19 of September 2017.
Okay, this educational video is to teach owners of Cocker Spaniels how to take care of their Cocker Spaniels. Now, Cocker Spaniels, they have the big problem is the ears. See the floppy ears. Now, many owners, they have to clean the ears practically once a week, because you can see if you don't clean the ears, then the dog will scratch it. It becomes scratched here, you see that? And then inside, later your eardrum, they have to clean it. This one is not painful, other cocker spaniels are painful. I think there's a bit of smell, yeast smell. Okay, now look at this ear is worse. There you see, all these are the scabs. All this must wash with warm water and some antifungus, and then the ear canal itself. In this dog, I think the owner cleaned the other side, right? So there's no pain, you see, there's no pain. No pain, but there's a bit of smell, but not bad. But here, the problem, he didn't clean here. He has to wash here in warm water, wash until all the flakes, all the scales come up now. This could be a sign of scabies. Sometimes scabies, you just have a bit of a dandruff. Okay, so number one. Then number two, you see the neck is also quite rough due to the dog scratching using the leg too. It's still scratching, so the owner must wash it and then get warm water, get rid of the scales. Okay, now this dog is very old already. It's about 11 years old. This is the 11 years old, you can see dry eyes. This is called dry eyes. There's no more tears already. So every day I have to put teardrops, no, dry eyes. That's why you see the pus here. Now, the teeth, when I done already last April, that means 5 months ago, teeth is not so bad. And just getting done, gums is in good color. Now, the other thing is for the old dog, lumps must be, must check every day. Now you can see, suddenly we discovered this big lump, see that? This is a skin tumor or subcutaneous tumor. It's a very big one. And the dog has been scratching it. Now this is likely to be cancerous, so big and so fast. Since we didn't see it last time. Last time there was a lump inside here. Inside here, but it was removed and there's nothing there. Handle, am I? It's inside. Probably this one you can see the scar. So this one is a separate one. And this could be the tumor of the gland, some mandibular gland tumor, which is not on this side. This side there's nothing here. This side is good. The submandibular gland is very small, then this is normal. This is normal and very small. And there's no pain. So we check further. All these are, this one the owner has to wash. Unfortunately, there's quite a lot of dandruff here. This probably infection of yeast, bacteria, probably. And it's not itchy, right? Is it itchy? Not itchy, but itchy below. Armpit, cold armpit. Then we look below, ready, 1, 2, 3. We turn up, so now you see. Now this dog is a very good dog. I've seen her from puppyhood. Now you see this one. This is the, due to the excess hormones last time, because the owner didn't spay her when she was younger. So due to excess female hormones, this part swells up. And but she was spayed 5 months ago, then spayed the scars here. And then her lumps, her breast lump above her. It didn't have. But that one is due to the ovaries. Now we can see below, all this must be washed. Probably put the dog in the bathtub and wash it. And other than that, you see the skin is okay now. A bit of dry skin. You know, check the inner side. You see how there's a coming out of what there. You see some here. This is a small starting of the circuminner wart. The wart is small one. So the best is to cut it off before it spreads to grows bigger. Now I'm going to check the oil glands. Oil glands. Inner glands. You check the inner glands. Now normally you could check it once a month. Either use a hand like when you use the tissue, probably a lot, you see, terrible. That's why the dog is biting, licking the tail. They put the dog on the table and press it out. Yeah. Then the dog will feel very happy. Now it's very... Owner didn't do for how long? Didn't do at all, so it stinks. And sometimes the house also has a smell which the owner doesn't know. Because the owner stays there, his nose is sensitized to the smell, but the friends who come and can smell it. The very strong smell. So the ointments are here, left and right. So just go and press it every week or every month during the bathing time. When you bathe the dog, you just press it. So then it won't be biting the tail. You can see the tail is hairless here. And other than that, we have to remove this lung. The only problem is that if it's cancerous, it's better to remove as soon as possible. Otherwise, it will start to spread. Sometimes it can be as big as... It grows bigger and bigger and bigger. And then the dog cannot eat. Most of it is a lymph nodes. Hard to tell. But I would say it's quite easy to remove because it's not stuck to the skin. Now there are big blood vessels here. The jugular veins, carotid artery and veins are here. So just be careful and operate on this area. Make sure that you don't cut the jugular veins. The dog will bleed a bit to death. So let's see, there are two lumps there, is it? One, two, three. Okay, finishing. 刚刚那。